So in previous class, we discussed about the charge density, and we also discussed about how the charge density varies with surface potential, how surface potential varies with gate to body voltage, and how the charge density does vary with gate to body voltage. Okay. So just to recall the expression for the charge density, I have written the charge density expression here. Qc prime here is equal to minus signum psi s square root of 2 q epsilon s na square root of phi t e to the power minus psi s by phi t plus psi s minus phi t plus e to the power minus twice phi f by phi t into phi t e to the power, basically this is psi s upon phi t minus psi s upon minus phi t to the power, I mean it's a square root of the bracketed terms. Okay, in previous class I made a mistake, I wrote here minus twice phi f, but this should not be. Okay, this is only psi s by phi t. So, as I said that this equation can be approximated in the different regime of device operation. For example, if we consider the case of accumulation and depletion together, okay. Let's say that either the MOS capacitor in accumulation or depletion. So, what we are considering that the surface potential psi s is less than the flat band voltage. Okay, so it is psi s less than phi f, or it's also it may be zero, it may be negative. So for this case where the surface potential is less than flat band voltage, you know that the electronic density in the semiconductor will be negligible. So we can drop this last term of this charge expression, and we can actually write down the charge expression QC prime equal to minus signum psi s into 2q epsilon s na into phi t e to the power minus psi s upon phi t, this first term, plus psi s minus phi t, these two terms together, okay, and of course the square root of this whole term, all three terms here, okay. And signum function is still required here, because we are considering both accumulation as well as in depletion region. So in accumulation, QC prime is going to be positive, because there will be hole in majority at the semiconductor and oxide interface, whereas if surface potential is positive, psi s greater than 0, then this becomes signum psi s becomes 1, and this QC prime becomes negative. So in that case, when psi s is greater than 0, there will be negative charges present in the semiconductor. Okay, so that may be fixed acceptor ions for a p-type substrate, or it may be electron. Okay, but we are actually we have to take this signum psi s here in order to address the polarity of the charge carriers present. Okay, so in accumulation and depletion, the above expression can be simplified like this. Okay, but still, if we concentrate only on deep accumulation means the surface potential is negative and large. Surface potential is less than 0, and also it is greater than some phi t in magnitude. Okay, then the expression can be simplified as So if you are considering the deep accumulation, then basically these two terms can be neglected, okay? Psi s minus phi t term can be neglected, because in that case, since surface potential is negative, so this is going to be a very very large term, the first one, and the second two terms can be neglected. So we will be able to write down the charge expression in deep accumulation as follow. The charge equation in deep accumulation could be is plus, means there is positive charge in the semiconductor, 2q epsilon s na into e to the power minus psi s upon twice phi t. So we have got a very very simple expression for the charge density. The charge density here can be directly represented in terms of surface potential using this expression, if we are sure that the MOS capacitor is in deep accumulation regime of device operation. Okay. But here we cannot get a relation, a direct relation between the surface potential and gate to body voltage, but we can get a surface potential versus gate to body voltage expression in the depletion region. Okay, so let us try to simplify the above expression in case of depletion region. Let us say that the MOS capacitor is in the depletion region, and in depletion region you see that the hole density can be negligible. So phi t e to the power minus psi s by phi t term, this becomes very very small and it can be neglected. Okay, because in depletion the surface potential is positive. Okay, surface potential is greater than zero and also positive. Let us say that the surface potential is above zero by several phi t, by 4 phi t or 5 phi t, let's say. So in that case, this term can be neglected. So only the remaining terms in square root are basically psi s minus phi t. But again, we are considering that the surface potential is few phi t above. Psi s is above zero by several phi t. So this phi t can also be neglected compared to this psi s, and therefore the charge density QC prime can be written as minus 2Q epsilon s Na into square root of psi s, surface potential. Okay, so in deep depletion, you know that below the silicon-silicon dioxide interface, the semiconductor is depleted from the mobile carrier. So for a p-type semiconductor, let us say that the acceptor concentration is Na, and the semiconductor was originally a p-type semiconductor. So when the area below this silicon dioxide interface, when it gets depleted, means the hole, majority holes will be depleted from this area, and fixed acceptor ions will be seen in the semiconductor. Okay, so these are the fixed acceptor ions just below the silicon-silicon dioxide interface in the depletion region, and this is the charge density of these acceptor ions only, QC prime equal to minus 2Q epsilon s Na into square root of psi s. And of course, you see that the charge density is proportional to the surface potential, means if the surface potential decreases, then the charge density will decrease. If surface potential increases, the charge density will increase. So when gate to body voltage VGV is increased, then surface potential will increase, and to increase this charge density QC prime, basically more charges has to be uncovered, and therefore the depth of this depletion region will actually increase here, and the charge density QC prime will increase. Okay, What is the objective here? To try to get a simple expression, try to develop an expression that can relate the surface potential with the gate to body voltage. We want to have a closed form expression that could relate surface potential with the gate body voltage. Although we tried earlier in the previous class to relate surface potential with gate to body voltage, but we
sir,
yeah
sir, can I ask one question?
Yeah, please.
Sir, what is the meaning of deep in depletion graphically, sir? Like in deep in accumulation, we can say that, sir, for a small change in this charge potential, there is huge change in surface potential, sir. I mean, for a small
deep,
change
in deep surface in deep in depletion means
but
when the surface
in graphically, sir,
yeah, I'm just trying to explain you. Okay,
okay, sir.
Let me have this draw this charge density QC versus surface potential, and here you see how the charge density is increasing with surface potential. Okay, so there is a phi f mark here, and then twice phi f somewhere here. Okay, so this region is identified as a depletion region. So when psi s, the surface potential is close to this phi f. Okay, so phi t, I said that when psi s is above zero by several phi t, means let's say 5 phi t. Okay, so when psi s is above phi t, few phi t, then basically we are thinking about that the surface potential is very close to this phi f. Okay, so when surface potential is close to phi f, we call it deep depletion. Okay, sorry. Okay, surface potential should be actually yeah, it's if it is greater than few phi t, then basically it should be somewhere here. Okay, because in this region we will see the accumulation in this region, basically we'll see inversion. Okay, so
yes,
when we move when we are moving towards the larger psi s value, so when the psi s is large and close to phi f, we can call it to be that the MOS capacitor is in deep depletion region. Okay, so under this condition we are trying to take this approximation. Okay, under this condition we are trying to develop the relation between the surface potential and gate to body voltage.
Okay sir, then we can say like when psi of s is nearly equal to phi t, phi of f, sir.
Phi f, not phi t. Phi t is different.
Sir,
thing,
phi
okay.
f.
Phi yes, f is much much larger than phi t.
Yes, sir. Yes,
okay.
Sir.
So we are basically interested in this region, okay, and not in this direction, but in this direction. Okay. So first we will see depletion, then deep depletion, then inversion starts, and then moderate inversion, then finally strong inversion. Okay. So when we are moving in this direction. Okay, first we'll see accumulation, then depletion, then you can call deep depletion, then inversion, moderate inversion, strong inversion. It's like that. Okay, I will come to that. Okay, I will actually talk more about the different regime of the device operation even in this class. Okay, so let us leave that here and concentrate on what actually we are trying to do. Okay, so here in depletion region, basically we are trying to establish a relation between psi s and VGB, and our objective was to derive a closed form expression. Okay, the expression the relation for VGB and psi s that was derived in the previous class, that was a complicated one, and that was not a closed form expression, because if you recall, it was VGB equal to VFB plus some signum function, then a square root of a large number of terms were there. Okay, so it was not a closed form expression. Here we'll try to have a simple closed form expression. All right. So we can use this expression QC prime equal to minus Ux Vgb minus Vfb minus Is. Okay, this expression is derived using charge balance equation and potential balance equation, if you recall. Okay, and from this expression actually the gate to body voltage Vgb can be written as Vfb plus Is minus Qc prime psi s upon Cux. Okay, so Qc prime upon Qc prime, the charge density is derived here for the depletion region. Okay, charge density expression is very complicated, but here if for deep depletion we have arrived to this conclusion that this Qc prime, the simplified charge expression, is valid in the deep depletion region. So this Qc prime can be substituted here in this expression, and then we'll be able to relate Vgb with surface potential. Okay, so let us see here how the Vgb is once Qc prime is substituted, then we get this relation. Okay, then we get here Vgb get to body voltage equal to flat band voltage plus surface potential plus this 2 q epsilon s na upon Cox prime into square root of psi s. Okay, and this square root of 2 q epsilon s upon na upon Cox prime, as we have already discussed, is body effect coefficient. Okay, so this is so called body effect coefficient. All right, so this term can be replaced by gamma here, and then we'll have Vgb equal to Vfb plus psi s plus gamma into psi s. Okay, now we have got a relation here with between Vgb and psi s. So to express psi s in terms of Vgb, we can make an assumption here that psi s let's say that the square root of psi s is equal to x. Okay, so if it is so, then we'll be able to write down this quadratic equation Vgb. Vgb equal to Vfb plus psi sa plus the body effect coefficient multiplied by square root of psi sa. Vfb can be taken to this side, then psi sa is actually considered here, because since we are now concentrating only to the deep depletion region, then psi s is basically noted as psi sa in deep depletion, because psi s is a surface potential in general sense. So since we are actually now focusing to the deep depletion, so that's why psi s is replaced by psi sa here, and then root square root of psi sa x. So we got this quadratic expression Vgb minus Vfb plus x square plus gamma x, and this can be actually solved here. We'll be able to write down x in terms of surface potential. So x equal to minus gamma by 2 plus plus square root of gamma square by 4 plus Vgb minus Vfb, and psi sa equal to minus gamma by 2 into square root of gamma square by 4 plus Vgb minus Vfb square, because x equal to square root of sa. So sa is here. So here we have developed a relation which is valid in deep depletion, and this relates surface potential with gate to body voltage Vgb. Okay, and here you will get a sense why the surface potential is why the surface potential psi sa versus Vgb curve. If you recall, the surface potential versus Vgb curve or Vgb minus Vfb. So in deep depletion, you saw that the surface potential was almost varying linearly with get to body voltage. Okay, then it was this curve starts bending and finally it got saturated in strong inversion. So in deep depletion, why the surface potential almost changes linearly with gate to body voltage, that can be seen from this expression, because this is square root of VGV and finally the square term is here. So you can see that there will be a significant change in the surface potential with the gate to body voltage in this depletion region, or in, you can say that deep depletion region specifically. Okay, so this is very very important relation, because this is directly relating the surface potential with gate to body voltage, and this could be used when we will try to analyze the MOS capacitor and also the MOS transistor in sub-threshold regime of the device operation, where sub-threshold is basically in sub-threshold the deep depletion like situation is created in the channel region of the MOS transistor. Okay, so this is an important development. Now we have got the surface potential for versus gate to body relation, although it is only valid in the deep depletion of the device operation. Okay, so after deep depletion, now we should look at the inversion region. Okay, so so far we have considered that when the surface potential goes above phi f, okay, when the surface potential goes above phi f, inversion starts. Okay, so in inversion region, what will be seen in the MOS capacitor? So we are considering the p-type substrate here. So inversion will appear when gate to body voltage VGV is large and positive. Okay, is positive and large. So if gate to body voltage is positive and large, then the inversion may happen in the device, and in inversion case the gate will have positive charge, and the silicon silicon dioxide interface, there may be positive fixed there are fixed positive charges at the interface, and below that there may be a thin sheet of a very very thin sheet of that is filled with electrons may be seen. So mobile electronic charges may appear below this silicon silicon dioxide interface, and below the thin sheet of electronic charges here the fixed acceptor ions will be seen. Okay, so these acceptor ions, as you know, are immobile, and these carriers are basically the mobile carrier. So here you see the distribution of the charge density, rho y is plotted in y direction. So this is actually reflecting the positive charges that are present in the gate region, and these are basically the positive charges that are present at in the oxide region near the silicon silicon dioxide interface. These are negative charges, mobile charges, electrons that are just below this silicon to silicon dioxide interface, and below that there are fixed acceptor ions. Okay, these are because of the uncovered acceptor impurities. Okay, so depletion region, if this is the thickness of the depletion region, then basically we can call that this is D. The electron are basically electronic concentration. To just simplify the analysis, it is considered that the electron will appear below this silicon silicon dioxide interface in a form of charge sheet. So the thickness of this layer, electronic layer here, this is negligible. This thickness is negligible compared to this thickness. Okay, so we can say that the carriers are present here in the form of charge sheet, the electronics carrier, and below that the depletion region is observed. Okay, So you can see here that in inversion there will be two different kind of charges present in the semiconductor, although both are the negative charges, but one is mobile. So let us say that the mobile charges are inversion charges, is represented by Qi prime, and the charges in this depletion region are represented by Qb. So these are basically the charges of the depletion region, and this is the charges in the inversion region, or this Qi prime is the electronic charge density. So now the total charge in the semiconductor Qc prime can be written as a Qi prime plus Qb prime. The electronic charge density plus sometime it is also called bulk charge density, but we'll call here as a depletion charge density Qb prime. Okay, so now we'll try to investigate how this Qi prime varies, Qi prime and Qb prime varies with the surface potential in the inversion region of device operation. Okay, so the total semiconductor charge in the inversion region could be written like this. In the inversion region, basically the exponential term with negative surface potential can be neglected, and also we know that the surface potential, there were terms here phi t e to the power minus twice phi f. Then you see the terms in the square root were like this in inversion: psi s minus phi t plus e to the power minus twice phi f by phi t into e to the power psi s by phi t minus psi s minus phi t. Okay, so in inversion, and of course there was first term which was representing the whole density, phi t, so I should also write that here. Okay, so that was phi t e to the power minus psi s by phi t plus. Okay, so for inversion I can drop some terms here, the first term, because this is representing whole, this can be dropped. Okay, then the psi s minus phi t term is present here, but since we are talking about the inversion, and in inversion the surface potential is positive and large, so this phi t can be neglected compared to this surface potential, because psi s minus phi t, psi s is a large, much larger than phi t, so this can be neglected. And e to the power minus twice phi f by phi t multiplied by e to the power psi s upon phi t. So psi s is positive and large, so exponential term e to the power psi s upon phi t, this becomes significant. But compared to e to the power psi s minus phi t, both psi s and phi t can be neglected. Okay, because this is exponential, and exponential term, exponential of surface potential, so these two terms can be neglected. So the charge density in the inversion region can be written using this expression. Okay, Qc prime minus negative charges minus 2q epsilon s n a into square root of psi s plus phi t e to the power psi s minus twice phi f upon phi t. Because in inversion region, you know, both mobile charges as well as the acceptor ions are present. Okay, so the psi s, the origin goes back to the acceptor ions, and for this term the origin goes back to the mobile carriers. Okay, however this psi s and phi t were neglected compared to this exponential term, and this phi t was neglected compared to this exponential term. So this is the total charge density in the semiconductor in the inversion regime of device operation. And as I said that Qc prime is now Qi prime plus Qb prime. Qb prime is the depletion charge density. We discussed some time ago that Qb prime is basically we discussed that the qb prime is minus 2q epsilon s n a into square root of psi s. So the qi primes, if I have to compute only the inversion charge density, then I must subtract qb prime from qc prime. So qc prime expression already derived, that was minus 2q epsilon s n a into square root of psi s plus phi t e to the power psi s minus twice phi f upon phi t minus this square root of psi s. So this is qb prime coming out from the qb prime, and this is from the qc prime, and this term is common in both qb prime and qc prime. Okay, so this is the inversion charge density qi prime. Now if you try to we can try to investigate how the two charges qi prime and qc prime are varying with respect to the surface potential. Okay, because the expression is here, qi prime expression is here, and qb prime expression we have already seen. So we can actually now justify the nature of this curve. So what is plotted here is mod of q. Mod of q means the total charges. Okay, we are not looking at we are looking at the magnitude of the charges only, not the sign of the charges. Okay, and at x-axis we have this surface potential, and the surface potential is now the spread of the surface potential is divided in four region. This is the point where surface potential is equal to phi f, and at this point the surface potential is equal to twice phi f. Okay, this is the point where the surface potential is equal to twice phi f plus phi z naught, where phi z naught is phi phi t. Again, it's phi phi t, maybe 5 phi t or 6 phi t. Okay, phi z naught equal to, let's say, 6 phi t. All right, so now let us first concentrate on qb prime. Okay, so qb prime expression we have discussed, it is minus 2q epsilon s n a into square root of psi s. Okay, so since qb prime is square root of psi s, so therefore if there is a change in surface potential, qb prime change in the qb prime will not be very significant because of this square root of psi s term. Okay, so any increment here, that is actually the square root of this psi s is taken. So qb prime is not going to change significantly with psi s. Therefore you see that the qb prime, although increases with surface potential, but this increment is not very significant. It's very slowly with surface potential. Okay, so this is a graph for the qb prime. Okay, what about qi prime? Qi prime means the inversion charge density. When surface potential is less than phi f, means when the MOS capacitor is in depletion region, so electronic charge density qi prime is negligible in this region. In this region, the electronic charge density is negligible. Okay, whereas when psi s goes above phi f, the inversion starts, and therefore it starts increasing slowly. Qi prime starts increasing slowly. Okay, and then this milestone will arrive, psi s equal to twice phi f. So when psi s goes above twice phi f, it starts increasing significantly. Starts increasing significantly, and when the psi s goes above twice phi f plus, let's say, 6 phi t, it starts basically increasing at it starts increasing at a rapid rate. Okay, at a very fast rate. Okay, so this is how the inversion charge density varies. Now if you would like to investigate how qc prime is going to vary, so qc prime is sum of qi prime plus qb prime, that means depletion charge as well as the inversion charge. Okay, so here you see that in this region the QC prime will coincide with QB prime, because QI prime is negligible, almost negligible in this region. So it is the QB prime that is going to decide the QC prime, means in deep depletion and in early inversion, it is the depletion charge that is going to dominate over the electronic charge. But after this point, you can see the QI prime basically dominates now, start dominating, and now this curve of QC prime will actually follow this QI prime curve. Okay, the nature of this QC prime is similar to that of QI prime. So when psi s is above this phi f, okay, and psi s goes close to this twice phi f, you see that it is the QC prime will be actually dominated by the QI prime. So in depletion and early inversion, okay, QB prime will dominate over QI prime, whereas in moderate inversion, later in moderate inversion and strong inversion, basically it is the QI prime that will dominate the QB prime. Okay, and the individual nature of QB prime and QI prime variation with the surface, individual nature of QB prime and QI prime curves will actually can be used to see how the QC prime, the the total charge density is going to vary with the surface potential size. Okay, so here we have we can now mention the different region for the span of the surface potential. Okay, so you can see that we have identified four regions here. So first region is this, when surface potential is less than phi f. Okay, we call this as a depletion region. So in depletion region, bulk charge dominates. Okay, this is the second region where psi s varies between phi f to twice phi f. Okay, this is called the weak inversion region. Weak inversion region. In weak inversion region, initially you will see that QB prime will dominate, but in latter half the QI prime will start dominating. Okay, so this is the weak inversion where the surface potential varies between phi f to twice phi f. Okay, then this is the third region where the surface potential psi s varies between twice phi f and twice phi f plus phi z naught, where phi z naught is can be considered as a 6 of phi t. Okay, so this is region number 3. The region number 3 is called moderate inversion. Okay, this is the moderate inversion region. Moderate inversion region. Okay, and when surface potential psi s goes above this twice phi f plus phi z naught, means this region. Okay, this region. So this is basically called strong inversion region. So far we have been talking about only the depletion region and the inversion region, but now you see that the inversion region has been classified in inversion region has been divided in three different regions. The weak inversion region, when surface potential varies between phi f to twice phi f. In weak inversion region, surface potential varies between phi f to twice phi f. In moderate inversion region, the surface potential varies between twice phi f to twice phi f plus phi z naught. And in strong inversion, the surface potential is greater than twice phi f plus phi z naught. Okay. All right, so these are the three different regions of the inversion region. Okay, and we can actually see the different characteristics in these three different regions, and we can actually try to model the charge density and the other characteristics in the three different region. Okay. Traditionally, I wanted to tell you that in older devices, when the long channel MOSFETs were actually popular, then the strong inversion actually started with psi s equal to twice phi f. Okay, when psi s reached twice phi f, it was said that the strong inversion arrived in the MOS capacitor, okay, or in the MOS transistor. But now in a short channel length devices, in a where the device dimensions are really short and have gone below 100 nanometer, you can say, then this definition of a strong inversion is no more valid, and the strong inversion is happens little bit late, and strong inversion is considered to be arrived when psi s reached to the potential twice phi f into 6 phi t. Okay, any question, any doubt? If anybody has any question, any doubt, please feel free to ask. Okay, no question. Anybody, any question? So
sir,
now, yeah, please.
Sir, phi z naught will always be equal to 6 phi.
Phi z is basically a fitting parameter, okay. So, it is not always equal to 6 phi t, but it is an acceptable value of 6 phi t. Basically, it may change with the device dimension, okay. If let's say that device dimension is even, basically, this term phi z naught has got physical significance in context of MOS transistor, MOSFETs. Okay, so there, when the channel length is scaled down, when the channel length goes below let's say that 100 nanometer, 80 nanometer, or 90 nanometer, then if we aggressively reduce the channel length of the device, then this may vary little bit. Okay, so it's a kind of fitting parameter, so we have a flexibility, we can change this, okay, to get the best fit with the experimental results. Getting my point? Let's say that after performing the experiment, your threshold voltage is let's say 0.7 volt, and while considering phi z equal to 6 phi t, we are only getting the threshold voltage 2.6 volt. Okay, so then we can consider this, we can consider to change this, we can increase this, let's say, to 8 phi t, and then we start getting the threshold voltage to 0.7 volt. Then this will make sense, this change will make sense. Then that's why I am calling this, it's a kind of fitting parameter. This can vary little bit to match the property of the MOS transistors, okay, or even MOS capacitor. So this will become clear when we'll talk about the strong inversion, and when we'll extract the threshold voltage parameter, extrapolated threshold voltage parameter for the MOS capacitor. Okay, so this will make more sense. I will actually specify this at that point of time. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
All right. So this curve, I suppose, now makes sense. Okay, and in one or other way, I have already explained this. So here you can see that we have tried to relate the surface potential with charge density with gate to body voltage. So charge density can be plotted with the surface potential. So that we have discussed some time ago, and the surface potential can also be plotted with respect to gate to body voltage. Okay, so this curve in deep depletion, in depletion and moderate inversion, you can see that the surface potential increases significantly with gate to body voltage. Then the increment rate decreases and it finally gets saturated. Okay, so when the surface potential psi s reaches to twice phi f plus phi z naught value, then it almost gets saturated, and we said that the surface potential has pinned to value twice phi f plus phi z naught. Okay, so when psi s goes above twice phi f plus phi z naught, we can consider that this is the maximum value, that the maximum value of the surface potential that can be achieved, and further increment in VGV is not going to change this significantly. So we can consider surface potential become constant, whereas when psi s is less than twice phi f, initially it decreases slowly, but when psi s goes below twice phi f, it decreases significantly with the surface potential. And here the QB prime and QI prime and QC primes are shown. Okay, so objective of this graph is we have already discussed that the onset of moderate inversion and the strong inversion. Okay, so onset of moderate inversion is this. Till this point, this is basically the depletion region. When psi s is equal to phi f, this is basically the weak inversion region. Okay, so when psi s is equal to phi f, then basically we see the onset of weak inversion. Okay, and this region where psi s is between twice phi f to twice phi f plus phi z naught, we call it moderate inversion region. So when psi s is just equal to twice phi f, we call it the onset of moderate inversion. Okay, psi s equal to twice phi f is noted as onset means just beginning. Okay, onset of moderate inversion, and psi s equal to phi f is basically onset of peak inversion. Okay, but as I said that psi s is not something we can measure. Okay, we can measure VGV because we are gate to body voltage, because that is given by external supply voltage. So we would like to know what is the gate to body voltage at which this onset of weak inversion and onset of strong inversion, moderate inversion will happen. Okay, so the gate to body voltage at which the onset of weak inversion is seen is VLO. You see, when VGD equal to VLO, at that time psi s is equal to phi f. Okay, so VGB equal to VLO is onset of weak inversion, and VGV equal to VMO is the onset of moderate inversion. Okay, so I would like to know the get the expression for VLO and VMO, and basically I can get it very easily. How can I get it? I can get it using if I look at this expression. Okay, VGV, get to body voltage, you are already familiar with this expression. VGV equal to VFB plus IS minus QC prime upon COX, and QC prime expression for the weak inversion. For the inversion, we have already discussed about, and when QC prime is substituted in this expression, then QC prime will be basically what is QC prime? QC prime is 2Q minus 2Q epsilon s Na into what? Psi s plus phi t e to the power psi s minus twice phi f upon phi t. This is the QC prime expression in the inversion region. So when I substitute this QC prime here, then basically this minus minus becomes plus here, and this square root of 2 q epsilon s n a divided by this u x becomes gamma body effect coefficient multiplied by this psi s plus phi t e to the power psi s minus twice p of 1 phi t. Okay, so this is the expression. Now at the onset of weak inversion, I can make some approximation. At the onset of weak inversion means I can consider onset of weak inversion as the end of depletion region. And in depletion region, what we can do, we can neglect the electronic charge. We can consider only the bulk charge, or the depletion charge is significant. So this term can be dropped out. Okay, and what will be left with? Will be left with VGV equal to VFB plus psi s plus gamma square root of psi s. Okay, so what will be VLB? How to get VLO? How to get the onset of how to get the VGV value at which the onset of weak inversion arrives? Can I get VLO from this expression? Anybody? Any suggestion? Anybody? Please let me know very quickly. You just look at the graph below and tell me. When VGB equal to VLO? When VGB equal to VLO, then psi s is equal to at what value of psi s VGB becomes equal to VLO? Look here. When VGB is equal to VLO
at phi of f, sir.
When psi s is equal to phi f. Okay. So we can substitute psi s equal to phi f in this expression, and then we'll get VLO expression. VLO equal to VFB plus psi s is replaced by phi f, and here psi s is again replaced by square root of phi f. So VLO equal to VFB plus phi f plus gamma into phi f. So here you get a VLO expression directly, and you will be knowing that what will be get to body voltage at which the surface potential will reach to the phi f value. Okay, similarly we can get the expression for this VMO. VMO is the onset of what? Moderate inversion. This is weak inversion. This is depletion. This is weak inversion. Okay, this region is moderate inversion. Okay, so onset of moderate inversion is this point. All right, and of course, at the onset of moderate inversion, there will be electronic charges that cannot be neglected. Okay, but if we can neglect this, then again we can use this expression in order to find out VMO. How to get VMO then? In this expression, can I get this VMO value from this expression? Anybody? Just like I replace psi s with phi f, here I can replace psi s by
2 phi f.
Yes, twice 2 phi f. So when psi s is replaced by 2 phi f, then I will be able to get the expression for VMO. Okay, please note that this VLO and VMO, these are basically the amount of get to body voltage to achieve the weak inversion, to achieve psi s equal to phi f, and this is to achieve psi s equal to twice phi f. Please note that this expression is not very very accurate, but because at the onset of moderate inversion there will be significant electronic charge that cannot be neglected. Okay, but you will realize in this course that this modeling is basically an art of approximation. Without taking approximation, you cannot model any characteristics of even a very very simple device like a PN junction diode. Okay, so modeling is the art of approximation. So a lot of approximations are made, and the approximations are valid until or unless the characteristics does not deviate significantly from the expected one. Okay, these approximations are valid. Sometime what will happen that when I take an approximation to simplify an expression, what will happen that parameter will the characteristics will start deviating significantly from the expected value. Then in that condition, what we do, we need to introduce some sort of fitting parameter that will compensate the effect of oversimplification. Okay, so in short, basically this is modeling. Modeling is the art of approximation. You take lot of approximations, sometimes physical approximation, sometimes even non-physical approximation, or less physical approximation is also taken, and to compensate that, some sort of fitting parameters are introduced so that what we model, so that the mathematical expression that we are deriving upon taking those approximations could predict the accurate value of that particular characteristics. Okay, so with this note, I would like to finish this class. I would like to stop here today. Okay, we'll continue this in next class. Meanwhile, if you will have any question, you can ask your question, you can send your question, okay, to me. We can discuss this in the beginning of the next class. Thank you very much to all of you.